Seriously, I'm so glad to see all of you. I have been having the best time ever, enjoying everybody's sets and, of course, our extremely generous audience. And thanks. Jacob, a Christian metalhead from Oklahoma, way to bust the stereotype, dude.
Yeah, man.
Jaren's a black man obsessed with chicken. Same. We're an amazing group. So we're winding up the end of the summer, you guys. Has everybody had a good summer?
Yeah.
I've had a good summer. My rat tail's getting super sweet. And thanks. I'm still super excited that we passed gay marriage in California. I had nothing to do with it, but I was super excited and invigorated by it because, you know, slippery slope. Gay marriage passing in California means that I am one step closer of achieving my goal of marrying a dog. But like a boy dog, because I'm straight. And dogs don't live that long. Like, that's this, like, recipe for success. They're cute, they don't live that long. Apparently in the Bible, if I fuck them, I have to kill them. It's win-win, because I've been married. You know, as long as you guys are being so warm. Some words on the NRA and on the Navy Yard shooting. I totally agree with the NRA that it is not dangerous for every person to have as many guns as they possibly can. And if some people occasionally go kill crazy and shoot a bunch of people, all we have to do is wait for those people to eventually die out, and then we'll have peace. It's gonna be fine. It's gonna be totally fine. And every time we freak out about a mass shooting, there's no reason to freak out because we've done nothing. We've done nothing to stop it or change it. So when it happens, just go, well, that happened again. Must be Tuesday. I'm an American. Like a sense memory in my head where I think I can get the fuck away with telling that joke. And that's a problem. That's gonna screw me up for future. So I grew up super Christian, obviously. My mother used to wake us up every morning and say, "Good morning, glories. Rise and shine, Jesus loves you." I know, memories. And we grew up Latter-day Saints, Mormons. And like, people take the Latter-day, like, the thing that you don't understand about Latter-day Saints is the Latter-day is no bullshit. They're just like, any second now. And so like, in my house, I always had my Bible and my little Book of Mormon out with my name and gold leaf on it. Just like, in case Jesus showed up that day. Because Jesus to Mormons is like the deadbeat dad that's gonna show up suddenly and everything should be clean, you know? And I feel like that's the point of Christianity anyway, like that's the bigger point, is like you just spend your whole life waiting for the other sandal to drop. We were Mormons in a red state in Texas. And I don't know if you guys have ever lived in a red state. Obviously you have, Jacob, but it's like you say stuff and people hear it differently. Like you might say atheist and they hear Satanist. Or you say feminist and they hear lesbian serial killing prostitute. So it's very dangerous. If you say free speech, everyone takes a step back and puts a hand on their guns because they love the Second Amendment, but they hate the Fifth. It's a numbers game. So I grew up Mormon, and people would have questions for me all the time, like, Virginia, is it true that Mormons wear special underwear? And the answer is yes, and the reason that Mormons wear special underwear is so that we can keep our bodies safe from you dirty, dirty people. It's armor. that you wear. And why didn't the Mormon Church let African Americans into the church until 1976? Two answers to that question. One answer was the government said that they had to. And this, like, Black Mormons are the most self-hating group of people next to gay Republicans. Like, it makes no fucking sense. Because the Mormon Church, you know, believes that the reason that there are Black people was that God marked you so we could tell them apart from the good people. Just so you know. Just so you know. Those ones, no good. And they will keep honey buns in their glove compartment, evidently. Which is neither, that's neither good nor evil, but just is a fact. That I've been told. Also, when you're Mormon, your parents, you get married, you get regular married, like everybody gets married to a dog or whatever. And then you go to a temple and you get sealed. And so when my father and my mother divorced, they never got unsealed. Like, you have to do all this paperwork and all this stuff. And you basically have to get excommunicated from the church. P.S. And I asked my dad about it. I'm like, Dad, what? You didn't get unsealed. Yeah, thank you. Oh, my God. I'm like, what if you die and you wake up and Mom is next to you, like, for eternity?
He's like, well, if I die and that woman's next to me, I'll know it's not heaven.
Because I'm from Texas. I find sealing interesting because I feel like when people say, till death do us part, and then they're married until they die, like, it was, they were ready. It's not, thank you, fake applause break. So it was super weird. So then I was 13, and my dad, we left the church because my dad wanted to, you know, smoke and drink and leave my mom. It's fine. And it was super screwed up because I was the only one who kept going to the church. And my dad's like, no, honey, we're Episcopalian now. As if you can just, like, make that decision. I'm like, so we're just going to walk away from, like, the talking rocks and the space Jesus and, like, the Native Americans and everything? Like, what the fuck? So, and that's the difference between being a convert and accepting to believe weird shit, and being raised in a religion, and that's the only shit you've ever known. And then the other religion's like, well, we have this other weird shit for you. And I'm like, I think I'm good. I think I'm full of weird shit. So at 13, I went straight from super strict Mormon child, good child, to atheist, just like from A to B. There was just no... just boom. And I've continued with it. I don't believe you have to be a Christian to be a good person. I do try to be a good person. You know, I'm vegan. And I'm here to represent, thank you, that not all vegans are crybaby pussy assholes, right? Like terrible whiners and pains in the ass. It's really just the men. That are. But it's an interesting time for religion and for Christianity in this country. It's a super interesting time for Catholicism. I'm really pretty excited about Pope Francis. Like, yeah. He's pretty fucking awesome, right? Yeah. He's a cool dude. And he's so much more popular than Pope Benedict. Like, Pope Francis, okay, item one, he's 76, which is super hot and sexy for a pope. Yeah. It's like, people are like, this pope, he's got his own hips, he can go out, like, fucking, man, meet up with the people. That's awesome, and he's kind of a man of the people, and he's, you know, from Latin America, and Pope Benedict's just, he just never really got on, like, he always looked kind of like he was starving for brains, and so... And he lost me immediately, honestly, Pope Benedict, because he, when you get to be Pope, it's one of the few jobs where you get to choose your own name, right? Like, it's stripper and Pope. I'm like, you can be, it's like, your name is Ashley your whole life, day one of your new job, I'm somewhere, you guys. He could have been Pope Sapphire. But he was Cardinal Ratzinger. All the names he could have chosen, and he went with Pope Benedict. The 16th, like cliche, right? Like, could have been someone who spoke to our generation by being like Pope Awesome Robot the First. Or like Pope Get 20,000 Twitter followers in a day. Or something. But Benedict, he got in a little bit of trouble, and let's just talk about that for a little while. So he got in a little bit of trouble, and could have been one of the reasons that he resigned. His friend, he allowed to stay in office, and you know, stay in his position, even though he evidently molested 200 deaf children at a school over a period of 35 years. Mm-hmm. And when you really talk about it and talk out the numbers, that's not a big deal, you guys. Like, what is that, 4.5 kids a year? Something. And in his defense, those deaf kids never said shit. Sure, they were doing crazy shit with their hands all the time, but who knows what that means? Who knows what that even means? But it is an exciting time, like, so, you know, far be it for an atheist to talk about where the Christians are at, but it is an exciting time for the Catholic Church. You've got kind of a real talking pope, and the church itself is saying, what is all this problem with these molestations? Like, maybe celibacy is not a natural way for humans to live. Maybe. You know, maybe it's okay. Maybe, like, maybe gay marriage is okay. Like, maybe, you know, if people are born gay, if God made them gay, how can that be a sin? It's an exciting time, and I so look forward to the time when two girls are having a conversation at church, you know, and one says, oh my God, Courtney, your priest is such a slut! I just think that would be fun. I think that would be an exciting time. Okay, I'm gonna put this mic stand back together. And Jacob, you know, when I was, I'm from Dallas, Texas, and I can do the accent if I have to, like, yeah. If I've been pulled over or something. But when people ask me, why don't you have an accent, I tell them the real answer, which is, I'm sorry, both of my parents went to college, and so we don't do that. A couple more thoughts so I can make sure and have the most offensive set of my life in Sherman Oaks. I am so grateful every day, speaking of religion, for anti-abortion activists and pro-lifers, because they're out there on the battlefields reminding women that abortion is not great. And if it weren't for them, I mean, we would just be having abortions willy-nilly, just for the hell of it. Because any woman who's been in that position where she has to consider it knows that it's a super fun and easy thing that she would love to do all the time. Just for the gentlemen, and there's a couple, just so you know. You know when you get your teeth cleaned and they scrape every tender surface in your mouth with a metal thing? Abortion's like that, but inside. Inside here. You know, it's like the audience went with it, and then all of a sudden they were like, no, we're not having it. We're done with that. They turned on me so fucking quick. I just want to let you guys know that one time I had an abortion so that the baby's birth would not interfere with March Madness. That's how super fun it is. My sister called me the other day. She lives in Texas still. She was in Austin. And I'm like, how are you doing? She's like, I'm really good. I finally got to have sex with a black guy. And I'm like, okay. It's like, yeah, it's hard to know how to react. I'm like, well, I'm glad you had fun. But I don't, she's like, well, I always wanted to. I'm like, well, that's a little, it's a weird thing to say. Like, that's a little racist. I mean, you're a fat white girl, obviously you can have sex with a black guy. I'm like, I just don't know why it's important that it's a black guy, and you're telling me this, like, repeatedly. She's like, well, Roderick says. I'm like, honey, if you told me his name was Roderick, I could have guessed he was a black guy. Like, I'm not an idiot. I can put this shit together. Some advice in closing, and all of you have been wonderful. Those of you who have had a 20-piece chicken dinner, and all the other comics on the show, and the handsome gentleman in the booth, and our lovely waitress, and William Morris, and everybody. I've had a fantastic time. I do want to leave you guys with a little dating advice. If it occurs to you, if you're talking to a lady, and it occurs to you that you would like to call her large and lovely, why not just say lovely? Like, doesn't that seem simpler? Like, it's shorter, just to the point. And also, potentially, she might continue talking to you. Thank you so much. I'm Virginia Jones. Thank you, your lovely booker and host. This is Alex Keller. I always fuck it up when I'm on the microphone. Thank you.